Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Easy Draw. What I'm going to be making today is this beautiful drawing of a zebra in the forest, and it'll be a very relaxing video. And for those who are visiting me for the first time, you may please consider subscribing, because I post new videos every single day and it's nice and fun and relaxing to watch. And most of the drawings I make here are easy to learn, and for beginners and kids or anybody who enjoys drawing with crayons. So first I take a plain sheet of paper, and we are going to be drawing a zebra. So first I'm starting with the legs, the hind legs of the zebra. If you are not comfortable with drawing directly with Sharpie, you could use a pencil to make a light drawing, and then you could color with a marker over it. So first I'm drawing the legs, and then slowly I'm developing the body of the zebra. The zebra is a cute animal to draw. I am sure every artist likes to draw a zebra. Now the face part. Face is a little tricky, but once you practice, I think you'll get the hang of it. I'm drawing the ears and the tail. The end of the tail, you can put plain black. Now we are drawing the second zebra, because this zebra just by itself is very lonely, so she needs a company. So we are going to be drawing another zebra. So cute to see two zebras at a time. In the same process, I first draw the legs, and slowly the other legs. And the tail. And now we will be slowly drawing the inside lines of zebra. And before that, I'm drawing a tree. These are the branches of the tree. You could use any color you want for the branches. So first I make an outline with the Sharpie. Same thing with the other tree also. I'm going to be drawing another tree just here. It doesn't need to be exactly like this. You could draw any shape tree you like. Just random strokes for the branches here and there. Like you see in real nature, trees are not even. Each tree is different. And it's up to your imagination. Any art is up to your imagination to draw in any shapes or size you like. And this part I'm doing the lines of the zebra with black pencil. Either you could use Sharpie or black pencil or anything that you have on hand. Crayons, pencil, markers, or anything. And the inside lines, it has to follow the same shape as the curves of the zebra. It should be in the same direction. And each one can be different size, and the basic shapes can be to follow the direction of the curve of the zebra. How beautiful it's coming. I like it. Same thing with the other zebra. You draw the lines with the black pencil. If you want it darker, you can just push it harder to make a harder strokes. We are almost done with painting the lines of the zebra. I'm just adding some more light touches here and there to make it look sharper. Yes, it is. The zebra looks beautiful. So now I'm going drawing the branches of the tree. I used a little orange. Like I said, you can use any color that you have on hand. First, I'm applying some orange on the branches. I'm sure kids love to make this painting because they like a zebra so much. It's very calming to make this painting. I notice that every day if you spend at least 30 minutes in drawing or painting, that will be so much relaxation to your mind. That's why so many paint nights are coming up. People enjoy drawing with their friends or family. It's very nice, relaxing. Especially crayons, I really love them. It feels like to be a kid again to make use of crayon and make the drawing. I also make acrylic painting, but I put that in my other channel. That's called Sit Back and Paint. But in this channel, I only focus on simple drawings and simple paintings for beginners and kids. With the crayons, you can do layer by layer, so you get a nice texture. And here I'm adding the grass or the lawn. Make sure to paint within the inside, outside of the zebra. Not go over the on top of zebra with the green color. So this green, I'm using a bright light green for that. If you have some darker greens, you could add that also, or a little yellow or anything. Anything that goes with the garden or lawn or... Yeah, I'm pressing hard on the green grass. And this with the blue, I'm painting like pale mountains, far mountains. Because wherever there is a zoo, there will be lots of open areas like mountain range, forest and other things. So it will be natural to paint mountains. Then on the top of the light green, I'm painting little a grass with the dark green. You could do any random strokes for grass like what I'm doing. Doesn't need to be exact all same size, just randomly strokes. And some yellow. There may be some dry grass here and there, so I use yellow for the dry grass, and for the fresh grass I use dark green or light green. Finally, I'm adding some birds. It doesn't look complete without bird flying, so I like to add a couple of birds. I have a blue bird, but you could use any color that you have. Similarly, another bird. Two birds are beautiful. Same blue bird. And I am touching the lines of zebra with Sharpie, so it will become more vibrant. Just the outline of the lines inside I am touching with the Sharpie marker. But it's not necessary. If you like it, you can do. Otherwise, just leave it as it is. I'm going over the green one more time to make it little darker, because in some areas I feel it's a little too light. And same thing with grass, little darker shades in between, and some bushes underneath the tree. Make it as natural as possible, and it's up to your imagination. And finally, I'm drawing the sky portion with very, very light blue. Make sure to apply it very lightly, because the sky is very, very light, and you don't want to look like a very dark patch of blue. Wouldn't look nice. and final touch with the Sharpie marker to create outlines. And little outlines inside the tree. See how it looks more beautiful when we draw the outline with Sharpie. And we are almost done with the painting. And if you enjoy watching my video, please consider subscribing to my channel. If you hit the red button and the bell icon, you will get notification every day when I post new videos. I post videos almost every single day. So you'll have something to look forward every single day and you can learn with me. I find that painting is very relaxing. I'm sure you do too. And thank you very much for watching. And please come again. Look forward to seeing you again tomorrow. And have a pleasant day. See you. Bye, friends. Thank you again.